everybody. Good evening. Welcome to the house of the Lord. We give thanks to the Lord for giving us strength to be here. We give thanks for bringing us in this place. As we begin our prayer and fasting, I'd like us to turn our Bibles to the book of Genesis. Genesis chapter 15, and we'll read verse 1. But the context of that particular scripture is the Lord's covenant with Abram. And a covenant is basically an agreement. It is basically a promise. And in the promise, we have the one that promises and the recipient of a promise. So we have two parties that would be tied to a promise. And we have a seal and we have a sign. And here the Lord is giving Abraham a promise. And I just want us to focus on the very first part. Chapter 15, verse 1 says, after this, the word of the Lord came to Abram in a vision. Do not be afraid, Abram. I am your shield, your very great reward. Do not be afraid, Abraham. I'm your shield, your very great reward. It is God who promised Abraham, and it is God who fulfilled what he had promised. So even as we come, we are coming expectant that the Lord who promised is faithful to keep that which we commit unto him. And so we are coming with expectation. We are coming with faith. The Bible says the just shall live by faith. And so we are coming with faith and raising our requests before the Lord. And he who promised is faithful. So as you have come in this place, come expectant that the one who promised is faithful. It is not about us, it is about him, because he has the power to do all things. So I encourage you to come expectant and to know that it is he who will fulfill what he has promised. So here is the word of the Lord to you today. Do not be afraid. God is your shield and he's your very great reward. Let us pray. Father, thank you for this evening. We just want to say, may your name be praised. May you be glorified. Father, we have come as your children to seek your face. And we know that when we seek you, we'll find you. Because you've said in your word that seek me and you will find me. We thank you, Father, for this time that we have set aside as a congregation to seek you. Lord, we pray that this will be a time where we'll encounter you. It will be a time where we experience you. It will be a time where we know you. It will be a time where we receive from you in the name of Jesus. We pray that you will assure us of who you are in our lives, because you are sovereign, in control of all things. We pray that, God, we will not fear, but that, Lord, we'll put our trust in you, because you are to be trusted. We pray, oh God, that you will strengthen each one of us, that, Father, as we come in prayer, that, Lord, you will hear and answer our prayers, because you are a God who answers prayer. We thank you, oh God, that we can believe you, and that when we believe you, God, you are able to do great and mighty things among us. So we pray, oh God, that you will not pass us by in this time, in the name of Jesus. We pray that, Father, we will receive that which you have for us in Jesus' name. We give you glory, we give you honor, and we give you praise. We lift up our hearts to you, oh God. May our hearts be lifted to you, O God, the one who reigns in glory and in majesty, the one who reigns forever and ever. O God, Lord of lords, we worship you. There is no one like you, Jesus. We just want to say thank you. Begin with us, O God, as we begin, and end with us. today, speak to our hearts, oh Lord. We thank you in the name of Jesus as we commit this prayer and fasting into your hands. It is in the name of Jesus that we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Let this be your prayer, that the Lord should not pass you by in this prayer and fasting. Amen.
Pass me not, O gentle Savior. Hear my humble cry.
Do Oh, glorious
Consider all the works thine
With your precious blood, we want to say Hosanna. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, for 2024. Father, this first evening of our congregational prayer and fasting, as a house of prayer family, as we are here, our prayer and our cry this evening, O God, Lord, you shall visit us in the season of divine empowerment and as the Lord expansion in Christ. Tonight our cry, O Jesus, you shall visit us tonight. We pray, O God, house of prayer shall never be the same again. All of us, O God, we shall receive our portion. Canaan shall never be the same. Lord, we declare victory over the land of Canaan. We have been praying. This sanctuary has been established in this land so that this territory can be redeemed. We declare victory in the name of Jesus. Father, tonight as we are here, if the enemy and the team, the devil and the team has any agenda against the house of prayer family, in any way to stop that, we will not complete this 21 day. So prayer and fasting, we cancel it tonight in the name of Jesus. We cancel death, accident, sicknesses, confusion, calamity, affliction, anything devil wanted to bring into our life, losing of jobs, businesses, assets, anything. We paralyze it in the name of Jesus. We pray blood of Jesus protection. We shall victoriously complete with the evidence, O God. Thank you, Father, for the servant of God tonight will be ministering. We pray you shall speak to us. Those who are here, those who are on the way, those could not make it, we pray your grace is upon them, O God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen and amen and amen. Please take your seat. Praise the Lord and good evening, church. Praise the Lord. The Lord is good all the time, and that is His. Let's put our hands together to appreciate our God. Amen. Yesterday it was okay. We do not know what happened to the power, but they are sorting out. May God's grace be upon us. May the God's grace be upon us. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, all is well. Hallelujah. Jesus is in control. Whatever ways the enemy tried to interfere, our Jesus has won the victory. Hallelujah. If there is power or no power, still we worship. If there is power or no power, still we preach. Hallelujah. All the glory to God. Amen. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Are we excited? If you're excited, give a clap offering to the Lord. Amen. The Lord has brought us to the first evening of our congregational prayer and fasting. First evening, we will have a candle night prayer. Hallelujah. Amen. The God is with us. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, you shall make it for 21 days. Tell him or her, devil like it or not, we shall make it for 21 days. Hallelujah. Amen. Let me take this wonderful opportunity to welcome you all to this first evening of our service. Sunday, Bishop, we were blessed. I'm sure all of us were blessed on Sunday. And Bishop just laid the foundation on Sunday, and he is continuing. Hallelujah. For Bishop to read, I will give him my mobile. Hallelujah. So let's put our hands together. Welcome the man of God to come and minister the word of God, Bishop Luquesa. Welcome, Bishop.
Hallelujah. God is good. And all the time. He's the one of God. Hallelujah. Wonderful, wonderful God. Tell your neighbor, I am blessed. Again. Again. Truly, we are blessed sons of God. Hallelujah. This is a wonderful day that the Lord has given us. And we are rejoicing in His presence. We are fullness of joy. Hallelujah. God is in control. The enemy is a liar. He has been defeated, taken a knockout on the cross of Calvary. So we are more than what? We are more than what? Conquerors in Christ Jesus, our Lord. So we give God the glory. So now, let's turn our Bibles to the book of Genesis. Genesis chapter 12 and verse 1 to 4. The Bible reads, "Now the Lord had said to Abram, get out of your country, from your family, and from your father's house to a land that I will show you. I will make you a great nation, and I will bless you and make your name great, and you shall be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and I will curse him who curses you. And in you, all the families of the earth shall be blessed. Hallelujah. Colossians chapter 3. Ephesians Ephesians chapter 3, 20 to 21. The word of God reads as follows. And to him himself, Colossians chapter 3, now to him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that works in us. 21. To him be the glory in the church by Christ Jesus to all generations forever and ever. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, we are so thankful that today, this evening, we are able to be in the house of God, and that we can. And so, Lord, our God, this is our prayer, that we are here because of you. Nothing else but you, that you should receive the glory. And therefore, we submit ourselves to you tonight, and by the administration of the Holy Spirit, to lead us and to guide us as we go through your word. We are going to lift up your holy name. And all of us, we are going to be blessed. Holy Spirit, lead us and guide us into the holy word. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 To God be the glory. So 2024, what is the theme? What is the theme? Hello? I can't hear you. Again. Hallelujah. That is the theme for this year, here at the house of prayer. The Lord has spoken, and so he has spoken. Hallelujah. So we need to move with God. Divine empowerment and expansion in Christ Jesus our Lord. Yesterday, we looked at the first principle. We looked at the first principle. And what was the first principle? Hello? Our faith. Hallelujah. Our faith. in God. Abraham, for him to be empowered with the land of Canaan, now called Israel, because he was a man of faith. Hallelujah. He was a man of faith. A man who could move from the place where he was to a place where he did not know where he was going. The reason is that Abraham trusted God, had faith in God. He believed in God. And that's why God can even call him my friend. Hallelujah. He was a man of faith. And without faith, it is impossible to do what? To please God. And so, even us as believers, we are now the seed of Abraham by faith. Not so. We are the seed of Abraham by faith. So now we need to be like Abraham. This year, in order to get that which belongs to us from God, we need to have faith in Jesus. Hallelujah. We need to have faith. This is what we looked at yesterday morning. And so today, tonight, we continue with the principles of God in respect of our theme for this year, divine empowerment and expansion in Christ Jesus our Lord. Hallelujah. So we go to number two. The principle number two. Genesis chapter 26. Genesis 26. Genesis 26. Verse 12 to 14. The Bible reads, then Isaac, sown in that land, and reaped in the same year 100 what? Fold. And the Lord blessed him. Hallelujah. 13. The man began to prosper. And he continued what? Prospering. Until he became what? Very prosperous. Hallelujah. Divine empowerment and expansion in Christ Jesus our Lord. So you can see this story of Isaac. Isaac was divinely empowered. And he succeeded. He was very much blessed. Very much blessed. And he continued prospering. So, the second principle this evening that we are looking at is hard work. Hallelujah. Hard work. Because we know that we are to be empowered as Christians. This year, 2024, we are to be empowered. Not only empowerment, we are going to expand in Christ Jesus. Not in anyone, in Christ Jesus. Our expansion is in Christ Jesus. And so, the second principle from what we've just read, in the case of Isaac, is hard work. We need to be hard workers. We need to be hard workers. You see, Isaac, in that year, because he was a hard worker, the man had a field, had a farm. He was empowered. He was not a lazy person. And in that year, he sown the seed. And God did his part. In that year, the Bible says, he reaped 100-fold. 100-fold. And the Lord blessed him. And the man began to prosper. And he continued prospering. Until he became very, very prosperous. So, beloved ones, this year we need to be hard workers. Hallelujah. We need to be hard workers. Just like Isaac. Isaac worked very hard. And that's why he was blessed by the Lord. The Bible says, I will bless the works of your hands. So even as this year, as we are expectant and we are very sure that this year in my life, I will be empowered. I will be empowered. And so if you are going to be empowered, then be ready to be a hard worker. Hallelujah. Be a hard worker like Isaac. And the Lord blessed this man. And he continued prospering because God was with him. So may the Lord, our God, this year empower you. Hallelujah. The Lord shall empower you with the land. The Lord shall empower you with the ministry. The Lord shall empower you with a job. The Lord shall empower you with a business. In all this, you need to be a hard like Isaac. Once you do the work with all your heart, then you are going to prosper. God is going to bless you abundantly. Hallelujah. God does not entertain laziness. Okay? God does not entertain laziness. In the book of Proverbs 19:15, the Bible says, laziness leads to deep what? Sleep. And suffer hunger. A lazy person wants to sleep. Enjoys sleeping. When he goes to sleep or she goes to sleep at 20 hours, then she will sleep or he will sleep even up to tomorrow, up to 12 hours is when he's waking up. Do you think you can be blessed? You cannot be blessed. When your friends, by 5 o'clock, they are already up, ready to do the work, to go for business, to go for jobs, to go for farming, to go for ministry. But you are just sleeping. You are even changing the gears. Do you think God can bless you? Not at all. So, as house of prayer, let us emulate Isaac. Hallelujah. Be a hard worker. Tell your neighbor, I'll be a hard worker. I'll be a hard worker. Hallelujah. And in Proverbs chapter 10 and verse 4, the Bible says, laziness makes someone poor, but hard work makes one rich. Hallelujah. If you are lazy, even if you are empowered, you won't go anywhere. You will be a failure. This is what the Bible says. If you are lazy and you are empowered, you won't succeed. Because the Bible says a lazy person, laziness makes one poor. We do not need, we don't want, and we don't want to see lazy people in the church. Hallelujah. Because God is in the business of divinely empowering his people. And so that they can prosper. That is the heart of God. That is the mind of God. Hallelujah. And in 2 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 10, the Bible says, if a man will not work, or if a woman will not work, he shall not work. Hallelujah. He shall not eat. If you can't work, if you are not a hard worker, you love laziness, then don't eat. Just continue fasting from January to December. Just fasting. Jesus fasted only for 40 days and 40 nights. But you, because of you love laziness, you continue fasting from January to December and see if you are going to survive. And see if you are going to succeed. You can't. Hallelujah. Because God does not entertain lazy people. God wants people who are hardworking. So we need to be hard workers. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So be a hard worker. Be a hard worker this year. Because God is going to bless us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Number three. Genesis chapter. Genesis chapter 30. The third principle. The third principle. Genesis chapter 30 and verse 27. And Laban said to him, please stay. If I have found favor in your eyes, for I have learned by experience that the Lord has blessed me for your sake. Hallelujah. Oh, hey, wonderful. This is now Jacob versus Laban. You know, Jacob went to Laban, the uncle, and he married from there. He married Rachel and Leah. And the man, Jacob, was favored by God. That's why God changed his name from Jacob to Jacob had the favor of God. And so as a result, when he stayed in the area where Laban was, Laban had experienced this. The man prospered. Hallelujah. The man prospered. Why? Because he was divinely connected to Jacob, who had God. Hallelujah. So this year 2024, as we are looking forward, that this year is a special year. God is empowering us. God is expanding us in everything that God is giving us. So the principle is number three, be connected to the people who have God's favor. Hallelujah. This year, my brothers and sisters, be connected to the people, to the brothers who carry God's favor. Then the empowerment and the expansion will have a meaning in your life. If you make a mistake, to be connected to someone who does not carry God's favor, but is connected to Lucifer, then you are in trouble. You are in trouble. The devil has come, three things. Number one, to steal, to kill, and to destroy. And the Bible says the two cannot move together. Unless they do, they agree. Unless they agree. So as a Christian, we are saying this year, divinely, to be empowered by God. In our ministry, God is going to empower us. In our business, God is going to empower us. In our jobs, God is going to empower us. In the family, God is going to empower us. Not only empowering us, but we are going to expand. We are going to prosper. And therefore, as you are walking in this journey, be connected to the people who carry God's. Hallelujah. Laban was connected to who? Laban was connected to who? To Jacob. And what happened to Laban? The money prospered. The money, because he was connected to a servant of God, to a person whom God loved, to a person who had the favor of God, to a person whom God says, I'll make the father of all nations. Hallelujah. And through all the nations shall be blessed. This is what God said to Father Abraham. So, the same with us. This year, please, be connected to the people who carry God's favor. Hallelujah. Don't be connected to conmen's. Don't be connected to swindlers. Otherwise, they will deal with you. They will deal with you. It's my prayer. Hallelujah. It's my prayer that this year, as believers here at the house of prayer, we shall be connected to the people who carry God's favor. Who will be able to help us, who will be able to stand with us. Those who can advise that this is the way we should do things according to the will of God. Because in whatever we do, we must do it to the glory of God. So this year is very unique. Hallelujah. Very unique. So, principle number three is to be connected to the person or to the people with God's favor. Is that clear? Number four principle. Genesis 41. Genesis 41. We read from 41 to 43. And Pharaoh said to Joseph, "See, I have set you over all the land of Egypt." Then Pharaoh took his signet ring off from his hand and put it on Joseph's hand. And he clothed him in garments of fine linen and put a gold chain around his neck. And he had him ride in the second chariot which he had. And they carried, and they cried out before him and bowed the knees. And so he set him over all the land of Egypt. Hallelujah. Oh, what a wonderful, wonderful story. Divinely empowerment and expansion in Christ Jesus our Lord. So, principle number four that we should remember this year as we go through is that you must be a man and a woman of integrity. A man and a woman of what? Integrity. You know the story of Joseph. The man God revealed to him that one day you will be somebody. One day I'm going to empower you. One day I'm going to expand you. And the message was given to the family, and the brothers hated him because of that dream. And then he landed up being sold to Egypt. And while I was in Egypt, another thing happened, a terrible thing happened. The wife of Potiphar was desiring Joseph, so that Joseph can have sexual intercourse with him, with her. But the man refused because he was a man of integrity. The man said, "I cannot do that. I belong to Jehovah, the Holy One of Israel. I cannot do that. I fear God. And I cannot do that, that I can have an affair with you, because I respect my boss." The woman tried all the tactics, but Joseph refused completely. And then she decided just to grab him so that he can have him by force. And Joseph left the jacket, the coat. And then the woman used that coat as evidence to accuse Joseph wrongly. And Joseph landed in prison because of integrity. Brothers and sisters, be a man and a woman of integrity. This year, God is looking for a man and a woman of integrity. God wants to empower you. God wants to empower me. God wants to use you. And therefore, the principle is that we need to be men and women of integrity. The man was focused. He knew his God. Though he was in prison, God was with him. God was with him, though he was in prison. So no matter whatever problem that you are going through, no matter people are hating you, remember that God is with you. He says, I'll never leave you or forsake you. Lord, I'll be with you even up to the end of the age. When we shall hear the trumpet call, God's going to be with you. Don't give up. Be focused like Joseph. And when God says, I've got a good plan for you, he really means it. He really means it. It's written in the Bible that God has a good plan for each one of us. Plans not of evil, but of peace. And to give us a future and a hope. That's God's mind. So Joseph knew he's God. So he had to maintain the integrity. Hallelujah. And so God had to perform a miracle. So the friends, the two of them there, the baker and the other one, they had a dream. Each one had a dream. And then they explained to Joseph about the dream. And because God was with Joseph, he gave the interpretation that baker, something good is coming for before you. Something good. Very soon, you are going to be restored. You are going to be restored. In fact, now, better than before. There will be an expansion from what he had before. But one thing I ask of you, remember me when it is done. Hallelujah. Remember me. Hey, remember me. But this man, you know, he had no fear for the Lord. What does he do? When it came to pass, and he was restored on the birthday of the king, did he remember Joseph? Huh? No, he didn't remember Joseph. But Joseph said, please remember me when it is well with you. That's the nature of some people. You can be good to them. You know, those people, they are in a different world. You can do good to them. But immediately they are there, they even forget about you. He's your friend. Someone was giving us a story. One of the politicians, he became there. From there to there. And his friend went there to see him at the office. And he could even say, who are you? I've forgotten your name. Your friend, Umunobe Shua. Mwebo and Mwebo. All along we have been together and he helped you. Now you are there. And then you go to his office. Everybody, remind me your name. That's dangerous. People who don't fear the Lord. But if that man was a child of God, he would have realized that I am here because of him. And I'm here to be a channel of what? Of blessing to the community and to the people of Zambia. And it didn't take time. That man was fired. Hallelujah. You know what he did? That man, he just declared in the office that, Father, this is what has happened to my friend. But it is written in the Bible, according to your word, that when you go somewhere and you are not received in the city, what do you do? Kunta. The dust. So I did that. I'm disappointed what my friend has done. So, the dust. Hakunta. It did not take time. That man was fired by the president. But in the case of Joseph, though the friend in the first place, he did not remember him. But God had to make a way where seems to be no way. God knew that his friend is a danger, is a problem. So now let me make a way for Joseph. So the king had a dream. And that dream was disturbed. He could not sleep because of the dream. Had summoned the magicians and all the philosophers and all that to come and interpret that, all failed. And that's the time the man who did not remember Joseph, he came to his senses. Oh, king, there is an Hebrew boy in the prison. He did it to me to be where I am today. Call him. He's going to give you the interpretation. And so it happened. Joseph was called. And the king explained the dream. And because Joseph was with God, he was given the interpretation. And after giving the interpretation, and this is what we have just read. So Pharaoh said to Joseph, "See, I have set you over all the land of Zambia." Hallelujah. The Lord is going to set you over the land of Zambia. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And Pharaoh took his signet ring off from his hand and he put it on Joseph's hand and he clothed him with garments of fine linen and put a gold chain around his neck and he had him ride on the second chariot which he had. And they cried out before him. They bowed the knees. So he set him over all the land of Egypt, from a prisoner to a prime minister. Hallelujah. From a prisoner to a prime minister, second in command. Oh, the vice president, from a prisoner. Why? Joseph was a man of integrity. And God empowered him with the authority to be in charge, second in charge of the whole entire Egypt. And this man, not only that he was given that empowerment, he also expanded. This man expanded. God can do exceedingly abundantly than what we imagine or think about it. Hallelujah. Hey, see what happened to Joseph. 47, 49. Genesis chapter 41. Let's read 47 and 49. Now in the 70 plentiful years of ground brought forth abundance. So he gathered up all the food in the 7 years which were in the land of Egypt and laid up the food in the cities and laid it in every city and the food of the fields which surrounded them. 49. Joseph gathered very much grain as the sand of the sea, until he stopped counting, for it was immeasurable. Hallelujah. You can see what God can do. When God empowers you, He will also expand. He will also increase. You are going to prosper in your ministry, in your business, in your family, in the land. God is going to increase you. Joseph collected plenty of food in Egypt, whereby he even stopped keeping what? Records. Just imagine when God blesses you exceedingly, abundantly, more than what you imagine. This is what happened, was fulfilled in the life of Joseph, whereby he even stopped making records. I remember when I was in Kabwe, there is a Jew, I don't know, it's a long time. This man, a farmer, this man prospered in Kabwe. A farmer, he's a Jew. He prospered, whereby he also stopped keeping records. The animals, cows, he stopped. Because the man really prospered. He really prospered. And thieves, they used to steal from his farm. And he cannot even trace whether it is his animal or not. He couldn't. And we are facing problems as a police. When that man is found, explain where you got this animal. Wah, 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 wah. You know, in those days when it was police force, he used force. Oh, I know. Let me lead you. In that farm. Going to the owner. This is the gentleman who stole your animal. So are you able to identify your animal? Give us a statement. But, no idea. No idea. I'm so much blessed. Joseph, the man was so much blessed. He collected plenty in Egypt, and whereby even stopped keeping the records. God's word is very faithful. When he says, I will bless you, to him who can do exceedingly and abundantly, it means it. So the Lord, even this year, will do it for you and me. As long as you remain as a man and a woman of what? Integrity. We need to be men and women of integrity. God is looking for such people, like Joseph, to be a man and a woman of integrity. Because God is holy. God is righteous. So when you are dealing with God, your father, be like him. Hallelujah. Be like him. It took me time, Pastor Joseph, for me to be given a plot. It took me time. Because my officers were laughing at me. But boss, for you to be given a plot, it will take time. Because you want things which are straight. But to us, we have got 2 or 3 plots. Because we use what? Money. And I said, that I cannot do. Because my conscience cannot allow me. I want, when I am in the house, I dare declare and give glory to God. That this house, this plot is from Him. Hallelujah. Who created me and who saved me. Hallelujah. Amen. So it took me time. I applied and applied and applied. Oof. 0-0. But my juniors, we are getting plots. I said, no, I cannot do that. I need to be a man, an officer of integrity. So one day, the Spirit spoke to me to say, go and see the town clerk. This madam, who is this madam? Eh? I've even forgotten his name, her name. Charity? Hey, Charity. Yeah. The Lord just spoke to me, go and see the town clerk. So I went to her. Madam, I'm a chaplain. Oh, come a chaplain. Yes, madam. I said, well, I've brought this complaint to you. Being a servant of God, I've been denied the right to have a plot. My officers, they've been laughing at me because I'm a pastor. I'm a police chaplain. So is it a sin to be a pastor that I cannot have a plot? Check in your records. All my applications were there. Applying for a plot, but nothing. So you want without a plot. Just as I am a senior police officer to retire without a plot. And she said, your message, so bad. I feel so bad. Is it happened that yes? Oh. I'm tired to from you from the message. And then she told me, okay, next week we are having a meeting, council meeting. I'll present your case. Come the other week on Wednesday, of which I did. And I went there. And then she told me, chaplain, your issue was stable. And it was agreed upon that you are entitled to. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So here's a yellow book. Name there. I found it there. And to God be the glory. Hallelujah. And then she said, go and see the director legal, Mr. Mumba, by then. And I went there to see him. And, we are opening up new plots in Hillcrest. So, our chaplain, we are going to give you a plot here. And then he looked at the map, the site map, He looked at it and then said, what? As a man of God, I will give you the best plot. Hallelujah. Integrity now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hey. And they looked at it. Okay, I'll give you here because this is the last plot. So all this is yours. 50 by 50. I said, to God be the glory. He said, wait, I'll give you a letter of offer. And he gave me the letter of offer. And then he said, go and see those gentlemen who will go and show you the plot. So that is how I was driving with a car, ZP car. I was given the car. So we drove to Hillcrest. And when we found the place, the plot, I said, God be the glory. God who can give exceedingly, abundantly, more than what we we ask for. Beautiful. And in fact now, even the council, we've been extended from 50 to another 60. This is what God can do. So when I'm there with my wife there, we said, this is from God. Hallelujah. This is from God. It's not about anything but Him be glorified. Hallelujah. So this year, be expectant. God's going to expand you. God's going to do more than you can ask. On a principle, be a man and a woman of what? Integrity. This is your year, 2024. God cannot tell a lie. God is a holy God. It's not like a man who can tell a lie. When he has revealed to this church that this year is a year of divine empowerment, he really means it. And it's coming to pass. Follow the footsteps of Jesus. Follow the footsteps of God, and it shall come to pass. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. To God be the glory. So tomorrow, by the grace of God, we shall continue. We shall continue looking at the principles, because this is our year. This is our year. Hallelujah. This is our year. Can we just stand? This year is a year of divine connections. This year is a special year. God is doing great things. So now, we have just looked at the principles of God, that we need to be men and women of faith. And we need to be men and women of hard work. And we need to be men and women who are connected to people with God's favor. And we need to be men and women of integrity. Just in a few minutes, talk to your God. Talk to Jesus. Lord, here I am. This is my year. This is my year. Give me the grace to be a man and a woman of faith. To be a hard worker. And connect me to the people who are carrying God's favor. Give me the grace to be a man and a woman of integrity. Jesus, I give myself to you. 2024 is a year of divine empowerment and expansion in Christ Jesus. So Lord, I pray like Abraham, a man of faith. Oh Lord my God, increase my faith. Without faith, it is impossible to please you. Help me, oh Lord. Help me, Jesus, Son of David, the Lion of the tribe of Judah. Oh my God. Jesus, you are a hard worker. I need to be a servant who is a hard worker. God, you are working day and night. You don't slumber. So I need to be a hard worker for the ministry that Lord you have entrusted me to preach the gospel, to go to all nations, Lord, make me to be what you want me to be. Lord, I pray. Connect me to God's people. Connect me, O Lord Jesus, to the people who are carrying your favor. Not the people of darkness, but I need to be connected to the people that God, our Father, will be able to honor you, who will be able to lift up your holy name. Jesus, oh, help us, Lord. The Holy One of Israel, we need to be men and women of integrity. Lord, I pray tonight, it's all about you, it's not about us. Make us to be what you want us to be. As a house of prayer, house of prayer. I was glad when they said to me, let us go to the house of God. Here we are, O Lord, in your house. Make us to be what you want us to be. This year, 2024, we look to you. We look to you, Jehovah. We look to you, Jesus, and we look to you, Holy Spirit, help us. Our lives are in your hands. Make us to be vessels that you want us to be for the sake of your name and your glory. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen. A big hand for Jesus. Thank you. By the grace of God, we are meeting tomorrow, that we continue looking God's principles for the theme for this year. May God richly bless you. Shalom.
Thank you, Bishop. Thank you. Please take your seat. 2 minutes, we have done. On the first evening of our prayer and fasting, if you have come with a tithe and offering, we have an opportunity to give to our shares quickly, please. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Bishop. Are we blessed, church? Are we blessed?
Yes, yes.
Hallelujah. I am blessed. Thank you. We are ready for the expansion. May God bless you. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord bless you. Bring someone. Tell our friends. Tell our neighbors. May God bless you. Shall we all stand? Shall we all stand? As our shirts are passing by, if the Lord has given you something, drop it. Then close your eyes. Just to meditate on the word which has spoken to us. The very biblical principle the Lord has been releasing to house of prayer. The first few days of our prayer and fasting, even yesterday, the men of God started with, hallelujah, touching our faith, hallelujah. And today, tonight, he has gone into more details and deeps, and we pray that we shall experience what God has promised. None of the house of prayer family will miss God's grace. No one will miss. We all will be part of divine empowerment and expansion in Christ, with a visible sign, not spiritually, with a physical, tangible signs in our lives, in our families, in our health, in our generation, in our jobs, in our businesses, in our ministry, in house of prayer. We shall see. People shall ask how it happened. We are able to say, we are in a new season. We are in a new season. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Father, we want to say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, for the word. Thank you, Lord, for everything you have done into our lives, oh Jesus, oh God. Lord, this evening, on the first evening of our prayer and fasting, thank you, Lord, for again speaking to us, oh God, very clearly, precisely and personally as an individual. Oh Jesus, we want to say thank you. Holy Spirit, we want to say thank you. Father, we want to say thank you. Lord, we want to say thank you. As we go back to our place, take us home safely, oh God. We cancel any of the weaknesses. Anybody's feeling weak or tired, we release the grace and the strength of Jesus, oh God. Lord, as we go, nothing shall disturb us, oh God. We continue to pray for your servant. Refresh him and bring him back tomorrow, oh God. May God bless. Thank you, Father, for the giving of your people. Return to them thousandfold. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forever. Amen and amen. May God bless you richly. Have a blessed night. See you tomorrow. Bring someone as you are driving. Somebody need a lift. Give somebody a lift. God will bless you. Amen and amen. Bishop, thank you so much.